The fact remains that for decades together, successive government at the centre did not accede to the demand for separate Telangana for reasons better known to them. But in December 2009, the central government unilaterally decided for formation of a separate Telangana state, although the decision was put on hold for long 4 years. Now, keeping an eye on the forthcoming Lok Sabha election, the government is reportedly going ahead with the formation of Telangana without addressing the problems of Simandhara, Royalseema and the related issues. Sir, this announcement has opened a Pandora's box all over the country, because already there is a demand for more than 20 new states all over the country. So it has created a huge impact all over the country. It is not only limited to the Telangana or Andhra region, but as my friend from Assam has said, Assam is burning, some parts of Bengal is burning. Kindly take the example of Gorkhaland. GTA, Gorkha Territorial Administration Authority, was formed pursuant to an agreement, tripartite agreement, to which the central government is signatory, the state government is signatory, and the Gorkha Janamukti Morcha is signatory. As soon as the Telangana announcement made, the GTA chief of the Gorkha Territorial Authority, he unilaterally resigned and also started demanding a separate state of Gorkha land. Sir, what will be the formation of Gorkha land if at all the demand is heard sympathetically? Half of the district, the hills of Darjeeling comprises of half of the district, half of a parliamentary seat and only 3 assembly segments. With this tiny territory, can a state be formed? Is there any state in India with such a tiny territory, having only half a district, half a parliamentary constituency and 3 assembly segments? If we concede to such demands, then there will be demands for city-states as it existed in ancient Greece, like Sparta, Troy, Athens, Olympia. The cities are sovereign, all are sovereign states, tiny cities, all are sovereign states with their own monarchs, own currency, own soldiers, and only a tiny territorial area of a city. And already someone has demanded that Mumbai should be a separate state. Tomorrow someone will ask Bengaluru will be a separate state, or for that matter Jaipur will be a separate state. Whether the government of India is going to accede such demands from different parts of the country? The entire country is engulfed with fire of division. The divisive forces and the vociferous elements, they are raising their ugly heads everywhere with the announcement of separate Telangana. Therefore, I think a serious relook to the situation should be made by the government of India immediately, otherwise the entire country will have experienced a very volatile situation. Sir, Bengal has once withstood the shock and trauma, the irreparable loss and damage due to partition in 1947. We have not forgotten that experience. Generations together, we are suffering for that partition even today. Therefore, we cannot afford to another division of the state. People of Bengal will never allow such demand for division of the state. Therefore, I want a clarification, a clear clarification from the Honorable Minister in charge of Home Affairs, because they are having secret parleys with the agitators very often, and they are encouraged with the reported assurances being given by the central ministers from time to time. I would urge upon the central ministers, they are responsible people, they should act responsibly. they should not encourage the piciparous elements in my state, sir. Finally, I therefore want a clarification from the Honorable Minister in charge of Home Affairs whether the central government will allow a demand for a separate state of Gorkhaland or not. In no unclear terms, the Home Minister should assure the nation, because the Mandarins of North Block and South Block, they have miserably failed to tackle the situation. And therefore, everywhere, we are suffering. This is my humble submission.